everyone, and welcome back to Python Pop, a series of quick videos explaining different Python functions and commands. And in today's video, we're going to go over the built-in isInstance function. Now, what this function does is it takes in your object and returns true if the type for that object matches the class info. If it doesn't, it returns false. So for instance, if we want to check if something is a float, we can type isInstance, type our number, let's do 4.5, comma, and then we're going to type float. So this is going to check if 4.5 is a float. If it is, it will return true, which you can see it does. Now if I change this to be a string and check to see if that was a float, it will return false. So this is very useful when building programs with any user input to check to make sure that the input is exactly what you need. Now, not only can this check for one specific type, it can check for multiple types. So I can do isInstance, and I want to see if any value is simply some number, whether that be a float or an integer. So I'm going to type 5, and to check whether it's a float or an integer, I can combine the types into a tuple or a tuple. So creating my tuple, I'll type float, and then I will also type int, two different types. Now when I run this, it will return true. Whereas up above, if I was checking to see if something was a number and I just typed int, and then I had a floating value of 4.5, this would return false. However, just checking whether it's a number, float, or an int, it will return true. And you can have multiple other values within this tuple. But that's just a quick overview to check whether the object is an instance of the class info. And with that, we wrap up this quick Python Pop video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Or if you found ways to use this function in your code, also leave that in the comments below. And as always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Happy learning!